closets are like adults. They can go out on the field anytime they like.
Okay. Can someone give me an example of an independent pod? Addison?
If I went to school again, I would have to go to detention.
I will have to go to detention. Okay. That is a full sentence. That tells you something, right? You're not left hanging. What if you just said, if I have to go to school again? If I'm late for school again. What is that? Austin?
A dependent pod?
A dependent pod, because it can't be by itself. Austin, can you read me dependent pods on here? What does that say?
Dependent pods are like children. They can't go anywhere unless an adult goes with them.
Alright. So let's read clauses in the middle. What are clauses in general? Madison?
These are words that contain a subject and a predicate.
Good. Alright. So they're groups of words that contain a subject and a predicate. So an independent clause is a part of the sentence that makes a complete sentence on its own. And, Megan, can you pass the question?
Can we go to the third one?
Of writing down everything that is said at this dinner event.
Here is the truth. Everyone speaks in his or her own way.
A conversation that would occur between these three dinner guests is the appropriate type of sentence. So with the people at your table, I want you to make a conversation that happens between these three people.
Oh, we all have to work.
You're a conversation, and you can shape just a sentence at a time. Okay? Like, Santa can say, "Maybe you're in big trouble," and then Mrs. Claus can say, "A big trouble."
Like a big.
You definitely were back.
And then Mrs. Claus made it
very bad. You know, she's just like mimicking.
Yeah.
Can we start? But
I know, that's why.